Hey, it's Anasaurus, and today we are back on our School of Dragons playthrough. Yes, alright.
Hey!
Danger is my middle name. We dragon trainers need to keep our flying skills sharp. We have to constantly practice. You put up for the challenge? I have to set up 3 different obstacle courses for you to get to test your stuff. Let's start with the Daredevil Drop. You'll show your courage in the face of danger if you conquer this test. Go to Gothi's house in Burke. Our house is the tippy-top of the island above the Great Hall. Alright.
Perfect.
Here we are. The heights might look scary on its source, but you can do this.
You got this. Keep it up.
See the flag at the end of the board? Grab it, then fly into a straight dive-off. Fly into a straight dive-off the board to collect the rest of the flags. Okay. Good luck. You'll need to pull up at the end of the dive, or he'll be a pancake. Okay. Oh, good. Come on, Sniffle Sniff. There we go. Alright. So, like this. And we just. I don't see the flags. Oh, that was probably a horrible fail. Well, let's try that again. Wow, that's. I don't know if that's much of a dive. Alright. Oh, come on. Whoa, what? Back. There we go. I'm not doing that whole thing with the flight suit. Okay, I got a couple. There we go. 2 more. Hardly diving at this point. Ugh. What? There we go. Oh, this is gonna be. Come on. There we go.
You're doing amazing!
Ooh, wasn't that amazing? I love making that dive on Toothless. It reminds me of the time we first flew together. All over the place, yeah.
Hey, got a moment to talk?
Now you've proven that you and your dragon have the guts to dive off Gothi's house. Let's see if you have the flying endurance to go with it. Go to the school and collect 20 flags on the outskirts of the school walls. Start at the landing circle. You know, what really surprises me is how Hiccup gets these to just float up here. Oh, we're going through here then. Okay. Should be smooth sailing from here. Just missed that one. Ten more. Where is this going here? Snowing up here. Oh, we gotta go through here. Down here. And these two up here.
You are on a roll!
Ooh, that was one marathon of flight. I feel like I need a nap just from watching.
You are on a roll.
You're acing these tests with no problems. We just have one more for you today. This one will help you with your speed maneuvers. Azard will help you run through the training. Go talk to her now. This is one of your favorite drills because Stormfly and I rock it. Oh, one of our. I'll give you a hint. If you want to excel at this one, you'll need to be quick and skilled.
Come on, put your back into it.
I place 15 flags around the wilderness. You'll need to fly past rivers and around trees and avoid the sharp rocks. Collect the flags as fast as you can. Where even are the flags? Oh, there's one down here. Oh, I see what we're doing. Come on. Now I lost them. Where are they? Oh, here. It's much easier to just run here through the woods. There we go. One right here by the geyser. And here. Son of a hatful, that was impressive.
I'm counting on you.
I'm going to have to practice and improve my times, or you might catch up to me. Go back to Hiccup and let him know how you did.
Most impressive.
I'm very impressed at how well you're bonding with Sniffle Snuff. I think you have a great potential to be one of our most exciting dragon trainers among us. Alright, cool. Saddle up, Viking. We can ride our dragons for long periods of time. That can get pretty painful for a rider and a dragon. I've been experimenting on ways to make it comfortable for everyone. I've thrown out some horrible ideas, but I'm getting closer to the solution. I just need a few more things to perfect it. Will you get me 2 black wool fleeces for padding? You can get them from your farm or from the store. Okay. Let's see, what do we need? 2 black wool. Black wool fleeces, okay. I'm sure I'll get 2. But not 3. Alright, this looks like it softened the ride for your back and the end of dragon both.
I could really use your help.
I can use this to create a dragon saddle. We'll need to gather 4 more things to make it. We need leather, metal nuts, and bolts, some small leather straps, and some oil to soften the leather. Help me find them, Huntsaurus. Hiccup's making a saddle. I hope he'll be able to do it better than I did. These nuts and bolts should fit Hiccup's needs. Here you go, and wish him luck. I'm not sure where I got these, but I'm sure you can use them better than me. Here we go. Thank you, Bucket. You want to soften leather? I have just the thing. I bought some coconut oil from Trader Johan last summer. That will soften leather and make it smell great too. You can have my old blanket. It helped me become the tough, gorgeous warrior I am today, but outgrew it years ago. Be really gentle with my blankie. These pieces by themselves don't seem like much, but putting them together makes them amazing. Please bring them back to me. Okay, give it to Hiccup. Yep.
Oh, perfect.
This is going to change the way we ride dragons. This is it. If it works for this time, I'm sure it'll work.
I believe in you.
Okay, I'll get to work right away on this. Would you go play Fireball Frenzy for now? I think Snarl's feeling a bit down. Now he gave us something that holds many of his childhood memories. He could use a friend right now. Alright, I'll go play Fireball Frenzy with Snarl out. Again. Hey, Hanosaurus, I'm glad you swung by. I need to get my competitive blood pumping to get rocking again.
Hey!
Eureka, the saddles are ready and they are amazing. Dragons fly much faster with the saddles, and they feel comfortable, so they love these saddles. Go to Yon's trading post to buy one. Oh, Hiccup. What a sellout. Wild Zippleback saddle. Novice. Oh, which one looks... This one looks way cooler. It's gonna be one for coins. You know what? I'll go this one. Go big or you go home, right? That's what Toughnut says. Ready to test drive the saddle? Fly up to the highest peak above the Dragon's Maw in the wilderness. It's just a short sprint to see how the saddle feels. I can see if there's any adjustments I need to make. Up to the top of the mountain. Oh, up there, okay. Boom.
Wow, that's great.
Seems to be a pretty good fit. Thank you, Anasaurus. These saddles should be a big hit, and I couldn't have created them without your help. Wolves are coming. Oh my, Hanosaurus, you have to help me. Wild boars have been coming near the school and spooking the sheep. We can't afford to scare any more of them, especially because there are so many being used for dragon racing. The sheep are so shaky that they barely grow any wool. Have a word with Gobber and I'll tell you what we can do. Hey lad, the wild boars are usually in the wilderness. I don't know why they would be coming here. We need to see what they normally eat.
Just what I needed!
I know. Go talk to Snotlad at the school. He spent some time learning more about wild boars. The boy has some kind of strange bond with all kinds of pigs. I'm sure he'd be willing to help. Wild boars are born wild. I was born a do-not-think warrior, so I can relate. Wild boars eat almost anything from roots to earthworms. I've even seen them snatching a snake or two.
You got this!
I'm busy figuring out how to beat Hiccup at Thunder Run Racing. I guess Phlegma can figure out how to get the wild boars out of the school. You can go talk to her. Ah, everyone's sending me to everyone. I'm glad you came to help out. We need to act quickly before this gets out of hand. Wild boars will follow the food and are omnivores, which means they'll eat anything. Now that we have been grazing our sheep and fishing ourselves for our dragons, their food supply is down. They must be looking for something to eat in other areas. When an environment changes, some animals adapt to some move to new locations, and some die. We need to get the wild boars back to the wilderness. Bring me 3 brown trout, 3 salmon, and 5 perch. You'll be able to find the salmon easier in the wilderness. Try fishing near the waterfall. Alright. That's a lot of fish. Well guys, I think that'll be it for this video. We're gonna finish that quest in a more passive way, where every time I go to fish, if I catch one of those fish, I'll just keep it instead. Because, that is a lot of fishing. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I hope to see you guys in future School of Dragons videos.